It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, reporting live from Grand Prairie, Texas. I'm here with newly signed Golden Boy Promotions prospect at light heavyweight, Tristan Calcuth.
Yes, sir.
Did I pronounce it right?
Calcuth, yes, sir.
Listen, man, you're fighting. You're going to be fighting here in your local hometown. You're from the Duncanville area, based out of Dallas, Texas, and you go to Grand Prairie High School, if I believe.
Yes, sir.
You're going to be fighting at the theater in Grand Prairie, Texas, man, August 10th. You're going to be making your pro debut. Explain to us the emotions, the excitement that you're feeling, man, knowing that you're making your hometown. You're making your pro debut in your hometown.
The first thing I'd say is all glory to God. You know, I'm filled with excitement, with adrenaline. I'm just ready to get in the ring, fight. You know, like I said millions of times, these opportunities only come once in a lifetime. You got to take advantage of them. If not, they'll go right past you, and I'm not about to let that happen, you know.
Listen, man, you've had a decorative amateur career background. You're a five-time national champion. You're a big light heavyweight. But you're only 17 years old, and we're seeing more and more often now in boxing where a lot of 16-year-olds, 17-year-olds are getting signed with a lot of these big promoters, whether it be Top Rank, Golden Boy, even Matchroom Boxing, the Al Haymans of the world, things as such. How amazing was it, man, knowing when you got the call and knowing when you hooked up with your manager, Lester Bedford, to get you this opportunity?
Well, we had multiple offers from Matchroom, Main Event, and at one time PBC, I picked Golden Boy and Overhead because I looked up to him when I was a little kid. I liked his style, and yeah.
But let me ask you this, Tristan: what is it that you love about boxing? What got you introduced to the sport?
Just hitting people and getting away with it. It's like I like competitive sports. You know, sports you can use your craft. You use your skills. You know, I have a lot of talent, ability. I feel like, man, really, thanks to God's blessings, I could have been a basketball player. I feel like I'm really athletic. I could have done many things, but I chose boxing overall because, you know, the discipline. The discipline is something that not many people are built with or could obtain, you know.
Let me ask you this, man. You're training now with legendary trainer Rodney Shields. I know he's been in the sport of boxing for, 20, 30 plus years. How is he as a trainer, man, you being a student of the game?
Man, Rodney Shields, he's a great person, you know. Speaking to him in person, having eating down, having meals with him, he speaks with a lot of wisdom and knowledge, and I like the things he says. He sees a bright future in me, and it's just going out, and it's just a different environment, and it's just, I don't know, man. I'm just great. I'm really grateful and humbled.
Let me ask you this, man. For people that may have never seen you fight, Tristan, stylistically, who would you say you compare yourself to?
That's a good question. I got to think about that. I would say, so I have good defense. I could slip. I could, if somebody throwing a punch, I could lean out. So that part, I would say Canelo. I would say that Canelo. And I'm also like slick. I could box. I can move my feet. So I would say Terrence Crawford. And like when I pressure, I also remind myself like a Jamal Charlo.
Nice. Well, listen. I mean, you're in Houston, man. So I mean, I'm sure you're getting some really good sparring. Have you had an opportunity to spar Charlo?
No. I think we were gonna try at his camp, but he's just focused on sparring people that are a little shorter because that's the type of opponent he's gonna fight.
He's gonna be fighting on Saturday.
Yeah, he's not gonna fight nobody tall. So, but I did spar. Thankful for him letting me. He let me spar one of his sparring partners called the. They call each other the Bell Brothers.
Nice.
Yeah. So. Yeah, they're good people, you know, good work. It's really nice down there.
Well, listen, man, you're going to be making your pro debut alongside, you know, a lot of other Texas hard hitters, man. You got Joshua Franco, Hector Tanahara. You even got the Rincon brothers here from Irvine. I know you were, you guys are somewhere from the same city, training in the same gym, so you're very familiar with them. You're also going to be featured on the card with Virgil Ortiz.
Yes,
young, hungry lion from Grand Prairie, Texas, man. He's just a big Texas takedown is what I like to call it, man. How special is that for you, knowing that you're going to be in there with a lot of your Texas stablemates?
Like I said before, it's all about opportunities, and opportunities come once in a lifetime. So that's this right now I see is really a blessing from a blessing from God, opportunity, and you just got to take advantage of that opportunity and showcase your ability.
What do you want to tell any of your fight fans, any of your family, any of your sponsors that are watching? What can they expect August 10th?
A show, you know, I'm looking forward to showcase all my abilities. So, you know, I'm going to be quick jabs. I'm looking forward to showcase my power and my speed.
Absolutely. Like any last shout outs you want to give, man, to you and your friends, family, and sponsors?
Shout out to my my pops. Shout out to my manager, Lester Bedford. Shout out to Elite Sports. Shout out to my mom. She plays a big role in this. Shout out to Ronnie Shields and Urban Powell and all the people that's been in my circle.
Where can they follow you at, Tristan?
You can follow me on Instagram. You can look up my name because I know it's kind of hard to spell it. Tristan Calc 302, but you can just look up Tristan Calc. Instagram, the same, Tristan Calc. Twitter, Team Tristan 302. Facebook, Tristan Calc.
Listen, man, we appreciate your time. Jimmy Blue, All Access, Elite Boxing.
Thank you.